Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech Ed. If you have not yet subscribed, make sure to click the subscribe button. Today here we are, with the three amazing MEMS based sensors that we constantly have in use. Number 1. MEMS Pressure Sensor. MEMS pressure sensors measure the pressure difference across a silicon diaphragm. Basically, there are three types of pressure measurements, namely, gauge, absolute and differential pressure measurements, possible with these sensors. Diaphragm is etched from silicon, using micro-machining process. And the measurement techniques include piezo-resistive and capacitive technologies. This sensor is integrated with a diaphragm and a set of resistors on integrated chips, so that a pressure is detected as a change in resistance when the membrane flexes. Working of a piezo-resistive MEMS pressure sensor. Piezo-resistive strain gauge sensors were the first successful MEMS pressure sensors, and are widely used in applications such as automotive, medical and household appliances. Conductive sensing elements are fabricated directly onto the diaphragm. Changes in the resistance of these conductors provide a measure of the applied pressure. The change in resistance is proportional to the strain, which is the relative change in length of the conductor. The resistors are connected in a Wheatstone bridge network, which allows very accurate measurement of changes in resistance. Number 2. MEMS Accelerometer. These are used to measure the static or dynamic force of acceleration. The major categories of accelerometers include capacitive, piezo-resistive, and thermal accelerometers. In case of piezoelectric effect, a voltage generated corresponds to the accelerative forces, which are acting on microscopic crystal structures on the sensor. Capacitive sensors are designed to operate by generating the electrostatic field and detecting the changes in the field caused when the object or target approaching the sensing area. In case of thermal MEMS sensors, a large number of tiny thermocouples are connected in series. Working of MEMS accelerometer. A typical MEMS accelerometer is shown in the figure. A simple MEMS transducer mainly consists of a moving plate connected to a mechanical suspension system, and thus onto a reference frame. The movable plates and the fixed outer plates act as the capacitor plates. When acceleration is applied, the proof mass moves accordingly. This produces a capacitance between the movable and the fixed outer plates. By measuring the value change of capacitance, we can deduce the acceleration acting on the body. Number 3. MEMS Gyroscope. MEMS gyroscopes are used to detect and measure the angular rate of an object. A small resonating mass is shifted as the angular velocity changes when the gyro is rotated. Coriolis effect is the deflection of moving objects when they are viewed in a rotating reference frame. This movement is converted into low current signals and measured using piezo-resistive or capacitive technologies. In automobiles, MEMS gyros are used for vehicle stability control with steering wheel sensor and rollover detection. In consumer applications, these are used in input device control of computers and cam recorder stabilization. Working of vibration gyroscope sensor. This sensor consists of an internal vibrating element made up of crystal material in the shape of a double T structure. This structure comprises a stationary part in the center, with sensing arm attached to it, and drive arm on both sides. This double T structure is symmetrical. When an alternating vibration electrical field is applied to the drive arms, it vibrates in a certain direction. As drive arms are symmetrical, when one arm moves to left, the other moves to the right, thus cancelling out the leaking vibrations. This keeps the stationary part at the center, and sensing arm remains static. When the external rotational force is applied to the sensor, vertical vibrations are caused on drive arms. This leads to the vibration of the drive arms in the upward and downward directions, due to which a rotational force acts on the stationary part in the center. Rotation of the stationary part leads to the vertical vibrations in sensing arms. These vibrations caused in the sensing arm are measured as a change in electrical charge. This change is used to measure the external rotational force applied to the sensor as angular rotation. Comment down which one of these you assume that you have not used yet. If you found the video informational, make sure to give us a thumbs up. Thank you.